Hey everyone, and welcome back to Splatoon. In this video, we're going to continue with the Inkling Girl amiibo challenges, and we're going to go through row 3 and row 4. And just to clear up some confusion, because I even confused myself in the last video, there's going to be 3 videos for each amiibo. The first video will have rows 1 and 2, the second one will have rows 3 and 4, and then the last video will have all of row 5. Okay, so last time we did the first two rows, and we're going to start here with row 3, and this is level 13, Shifting Splatforms. Oh, you get a lot of gold for this one, too. You know, I wonder how much gold I'm going to have once I complete all of these. The only thing is, I'm still not sure if I'm going to start online in the middle of these challenges, so... yeah, I don't know how much I'm going to have total. I'm sure you get a lot from doing these, though. Because it seems like the amount of gold you get increases as you go through like the later levels. Which is understandable, because some of these levels are probably going to get more difficult. Well, with this weapon, anyway. I mean, well, they did get a little bit more difficult in the story mode, too. Okay. Let's go over here. Try to snipe out some of these, were they called octocopters or something like that? Oh, he's too far away. Okay, there we go. Alright, that's the rest of the enemies in this part anyway. Oh! That would have been bad. Okay, there's some armor there, which I do want to get. I also wanted to be on the safe side, too. Okay. Of course, the scroll was over here on the right, and just in case you missed the first video, in place of the scrolls, there are just more power eggs. There we go. You know, so far it doesn't seem like there's a lot in them. I mean, I guess because... Well, no, you can start these... Like I said in the first video, you can start these amiibo challenges as long as you go through the levels. Like, you don't have to complete the full story mode, except for, like, some of the later levels. But, anyway, I'm guessing it's just because the locations are mostly going to be known. So that's why, you know, there's not much of a reward for going to those spots anymore. I'll wait. Oh, I missed the... There was some power eggs behind that, that jump. Oh, you can't see from here, but if you turn around, there was, like, I think some balloons. I really wanted to get those too. Actually, I think I forgot those in the story mode upload as well. See, that guy's much less like annoying to deal with, since you can snipe him out here. That's always good. Oh. That's pretty cool. You can set like a little path for yourself before, you know, you even step on the platforms. So that's another advantage of using this weapon here. Oh, that's cool. It, like, smeared as it was moving. That attention to detail, though. Okay. Do a little climb here. Okay. All Alright, that's another level down. I don't think that one took that long. You know, I never really time my videos, so sometimes they end up longer or shorter than I'd like them to be. I mean, not that it matters, I'm just going to go through row 3 and 4 regardless. But anyway, oh. Okay, here's level 14, Octoling Assault. And this is one of the levels I talked about in the last video that I might have trouble with. Just because these are like... they're smarter opponents, basically. I mean, I know the charger, I mean, you could stand around, but you're putting it yourself at a disadvantage if you do that. So yeah, I mean, you do want to move around so you just don't get, like, splatted by just standing there. Oh! No, no! Okay. There should be some interesting practice, though. Is she around? Oh! Oh, shoot! Might get splatted. Ah, I got stuck in that ink. I don't think there's a penalty for that. Oh no, yeah, because you just have 3 lives like usual. Okay, that that could have been better there. Oh, jeez, right here. Okay, I hear an Octoling somewhere. Oh, there. Alright, that's gonna be useful. Oh, shoot. No, no! Oh. Well, there goes my armor. Oh, yeah, this is definitely, like, kind of difficult. Well, for me. Yeah, she's put down too much ink. That was a little anticlimactic, wasn't it? Just ran into a bomb. Okay, final checkpoints. There's armor. I think I need that. Hey, where's that Octoling? I know there's... Yeah, there's one right there. See, one of the problems I'm having is a lot of the Octoling ink has already been laid down, so it's hard to, like, maneuver. Shoot. See, with the Octolings, if you can get them in stuck in your ink... Oh, shoot. This isn't working because, you know, the charger isn't really good for close-up encounters, so. I'm shooting bombs at each other. I wonder if I can go up this way, if I can surprise the Octoling. Yeah, I mean, I could exit here, but I'm also wanting that scroll. Where'd she go? Oh, there. Oh, shoot. I keep running out of ink too fast. Oh. There we go. Okay. Well, that's not the last one. There's actually another one that spawns when you... Actually, can I shoot that from here? It'd be awesome if I could. No. I can shoot from here, though. I think. Yeah, there's usually another Octoling that spawns after you get that. There's nothing in that? Okay, I think I'm good. I don't know what happened to that Octoling that usually spawns there in the regular level, but I think I'm good now. Okay, so yeah, that is... I mean, the thing is, though, when you fight online against other people, that ink isn't always, I mean, immediately laid down. I mean, obviously, if you're in their base or something, or if they're all over the place, that's going to be the case, but, yeah, I mean, I'm sure there's going to be other levels, I think, with those, right? Oh, no, maybe not. Ugh, okay. This next level might be annoying, though. Oh, wait, no, they're right here. Ooh, that one's tougher than this one here. Okay, anyway, this one might be a problem because it has the Ink Striker, but we'll see. This is level 15, Undeniable Flying Object. Okay, and then after this, we have the boss. And that's the striker there. See, it's gonna be hard to like get some of this aiming down because, you know, it takes a little bit of time to aim. But you don't want to stand around too long because you're gonna get shot by the ink strike. Oh! I do think it's cool, like, you can actually see the ink strike being launched. Up. Okay, I don't really need to fully explore the level. I was going to, but I kind of want this level to be over faster than usual, I guess. Oh, there goes my armor. Ah. I think I'm being a little too reckless. Oh, I could have just shot this. Ah, I didn't notice that until he was dead already. Oh yeah, as you can see from that Miiverse post there, Team Roller Coaster did win in the last Splatfest. Also, like I mentioned, I didn't participate in that. I don't want to drag my team down, but I would have picked Team Water Slide. Oh, the scroll's not down. Oh, that was a different level. I think this was the one. Oh! Oh my gosh. I think I should have been a little bit more careful there. Okay, well, we're up here now. Oh, that would have been cool if I could just snipe him out immediately. Oh, shoot. Ah, man. I was trying to, like, charge up the shot. It ended up costing me, though. I'm, like, right under this dude. Man, how many hits? I guess he doesn't launch it if you're right under him, which makes sense because he'd be hitting himself. Okay, yeah, getting rid of him is a little bit more difficult. But hitting those enemies from far away was pretty satisfying. Okay. And like I said, you don't really get penalized for dying. It's just, you just have to complete the challenge itself. Like, it doesn't seem like you're... Wait, did it go down? I don't think it does. Okay, and last one in this row is the Rampaging Octowhirl. This is boss number 3, and we get some shoes. I think before it was like a something for like a head accessory. So this one we have shoes. Okay, I could see this one being more difficult with this. Because you have to charge up the shots. Yeah, this... I'm not really looking forward to fighting him with this. Yep. Alright, I'm just gonna have to... Actually, I might have to utilize some bombs, too. Yeah, not quite. I feel like this boss fight will take a while. Yeah, it's not worth it charging up to hit that tentacle, just mash the ZR button. I noticed that with the other bosses too, it just takes too long. But yeah, it seems like it'll take more than one trip to like set up to get him in the green ink. I think it's every time he goes through, he like messes up everything here. See? So you gotta start, not really start over, but you gotta re-ink a lot of this. This is really annoying with this weapon. Especially compared to the other boss fights. They weren't that bad with this. Okay, that seemed like it was close. He was like slowing down a little bit. Ah. There we go. Okay, now this last part will probably take forever. Oh man. Yeah, at least I don't have to worry about like the glass parts, but still. Alright, I'm gonna try to ink up all this stuff as much as possible. Shoot. I just, like, it's really annoying how he just messes up everything after he goes through once. Oh, he got in! I didn't expect him to get in so soon. It didn't seem like I had that much ink on the ground. Well, that works. Not gonna complain about that. What was... Oh yeah, boss number 4. That actually should be pretty interesting with the charger, too. I'm actually wondering how that's going to be with a roller. But we still have a little bit of ways to go before that. So here is the stuffed Zapfish for boss 3. I think there are some tough levels up ahead. Ink Saver Sub. Oh, okay. Use up like less ink for the sub weapon. That might be pretty cool. Like, I don't know how good this equipment is. I haven't applied any of it on yet. But, yeah, we'll see. Anyway, this is level 16 Propeller Lift Fortress. This one might take a little bit. I feel like this might be a lengthy one. Oops. And like the non-fully charged shots, they're just so weak. I wonder if I can hit him from here. Yeah. That's cool. Okay, well, getting these to come out with a charger shouldn't be too bad. It's just, you know, doing like the weak hits. Oh, no, that's alright. I don't think it's as effective as the default gun, though. Yeah, inking up the sides like that takes forever. I was gonna go for that armor, but I don't really need it. Well, now it's bugging me because I can get 10 extra power eggs. Was it 10 if I stick around with that? Let's see if I can get it. Yeah, that wasn't so bad. Ah, if only got... Well, I kind of aimed that at the left, so I don't think I was going to get the guy on the right anyway. Oops. I will get that. Okay, this is going to be useful for fighting these guys. Hey, they saw me from here? Huh. Well, even then, they didn't really do anything. Let's get that out again. Ooh, that was close. Almost fell off. Hello. Alright, this doesn't seem too bad so far, and it's actually going by a little bit faster than I thought it would, too. Thought this would take forever. Okay, cool. Made it. Actually, something interesting is, since I don't have to get the scroll, I can just aim at the box that's in place of the scroll, and, I should be alright. Wait, can I not hit that from here? I don't remember if you can or not. I mean, it doesn't matter. Maybe not. Okay. I forgot about the balloons. Oh, there's more balloons. More enemies. Out of my way. Okay, well, I think I could still hit that from here. Yep. Like, risking my life here for 2 power eggs. Maybe if I stand out here a little bit. There we go. And then the one up here. Okay, cool. So like I said, I don't even need to really upgrade the offline stuff, because I'm not even using that default weapon for these challenges, so it doesn't matter that much. Oh, I just remember what this part is. I'm gonna use it, I don't care. Here's the other one. Oh! Let's do this. Just at least until I get my ink back. Where are you? They're down there. Oh! Okay, good. I was just like mashing ZR. You know what? This would have been great too. Oh, that's it. Okay, cool. Okay, well, I think that was the first one of row 4, so we have 2 more levels and then the boss fight. I'm actually looking forward to that boss fight, because I gotta wonder how easy it is to get rid of those teeth on the boss. I have a lot of coins now. Okay. Level 17, Octo Sniper Ramparts. Yeah, I think even if I do get a lot of coins from doing all these challenges, I feel like they're just gonna get spent very, very quickly. Okay, this is interesting because I have a sniper weapon. They have a sniper weapon. I'm gonna get rid of him first. Oh shoot. You know what? Take that. Okay, this isn't as easy as I thought it would be. I thought I could just like snipe him out, but I have to charge the weapon and... I mean, it seems like he does charge his shot a little bit there. Okay, but yeah, this should be a very interesting level with this weapon. Okay, and like I said, was that earlier in the last video or something like that, the next one is going to be the Inkling Squid. And his challenges are more unique, because it's not just going through like a story mode level with a different weapon, you're actually going through a level with certain conditions like limited ink, stuff like that. Okay, that went nowhere. He might be annoying to deal with. There you go. Oh, he can actually see me from there. Oh! I just noticed that his line of sight was on me. Oh, there's nothing down here? I mean, this is where the scroll was, but there's no crate or anything. That's a little disappointing. That might be the first instance where that happened. Right, how did... Get him, get him. Yeah. Okay, yeah, so this level's pretty fun with this weapon. Yeah, sniper versus sniper, it's pretty cool. Now, I don't know offhand yet if you have to do this level with the roller, but I can imagine that being really annoying. Hopefully the level selection is different, or at least like a little different, so you don't have to do the same specific chapters over and over again. Wow, that almost got me directly. think what I need to do is get to like a safe spot over there, because I don't think I can snipe him out from here. Yeah, not quite. And I really wish I had a different bomb. Oh, he fell down there. Okay, well, once he turns, like, not all the way around, but out of my sight. Okay. That was easy enough. And this other guy is still stuck down there. Oh, wait, this is all tarp. Ow. I'm gonna have to go up there. Like, around to go up there. This cleaning robot's, like, really annoying. Oh, he didn't see it. Cool. Okay, so his sight is a little bit better than mine, because I can't aim at him, but he can aim at me. Whoa. Apparently he can see through walls a little bit, too. No, he probably knew I was there. Oops. Ah, no range on that. Yeah, I'm gonna try to snipe him out. Might wait till he's, not looking this way. Got him. So much easier with this. I think this should be the final one. Yep. You know, I didn't notice until, like, after I beat the game that the music changes for the final checkpoint. Like, slightly changes. Alright, that was cool. I wonder if I can hit him from here. Oh, yes I can. He almost got me, though. Probably get him too. Oh, yeah, he didn't even see me. Okay, that's another one where he can aim at me, but I can't aim at him because I'm too far. Not anymore. I just needed, like, a little bit more time, and I could have sniped them out. Oh! He saw me. Okay, that was a little sloppy, but I got him without getting hit. Okay, and here's the next stuffed Zapfish. So the next level is something I'm not looking forward to, because it's another, like, one where you fight the Octolings, and the Octolings here are more intelligent and tough. Okay, next up is Octoling Uprising. I actually like the level name here. I actually used it for a video title as well. Okay, I don't know if it's gonna mention it here. No, okay. These Octoling with, like, the kelp on their heads and the dark hair, they are, like, elite ones. They're smarter than, regular ones. I kind of got lucky with that shot there. Oh, there's another one. Where is she? Oh! That's a regular one. Okay, this level I'm gonna not explore as much, because I really want this one done as soon as possible, and I apologize if you can hear rain in the background. It's raining really hard outside right now. Oh! Ow. The Octolings all have, like, the ones in this level, they all have the regular gun, so they're able to spread ink faster. Oh, she's getting right in my face. Ah, it's so hard. I'm trying to, like, lure her over here because all my ink is on this side. She keeps, like, inking all over it. Okay, I think I could have gotten her there. Ah, okay. I think there's a power-up. Yeah. I don't know if I showed this in the main playthrough, but this is interesting. When you activate it, you can shoot bombs for, like, an unlimited amount of time. For a few seconds. Oh, and there's somebody over there. Oops. Like, I want to jump down, but I'm afraid to, like, jump down into a bomb. Okay, this isn't working. Oh! Fine, I'll come down here. Where are you? If only I was able to snipe her out, like, immediately, that would have been awesome. I see you. Okay. I want to get rid of you. I can't read what that says, but something about Splatfest. Okay, so let's go up here. Oh, this part I had trouble with before. I wonder if I could just snipe her out. Yep. And then there's somebody on the top part over here, too. I'm just gonna use this now. I never did use that bomb power up, but you might see me use that online or something. Oh. Oh, I almost got her. Oh. No. There we go. Wow, this is, like, difficult for me. Wait, why did they give you that if that was the last enemy? I'm pretty sure that was the last enemy. Okay, well, anyway, we are done with this level. Yeah. Oh, okay, that was insane. I think that was the craziest one so far. Okay, cool. So the last one in this video is going to be boss number 4. This is the fight against Octomaw. And you get a mini game for this. Looks interesting. It's like Zapfish Volleyball. Okay. Yeah, this could be either really easy or more annoying with the charger. I mean, I don't think shooting out the teeth is going to be a problem, but yeah, I'll find out. This was probably my favorite boss fight. Well, except for the final boss. The final boss is really cool, too. Okay. I can see getting out of that being pretty difficult because you need to charge up, like, a shot to get rid of the teeth. Oops. There we go. Yeah, the problem I see with this one is when he tries to eat you, his mouth is full of the purple ink. You know, since the charger doesn't spread ink that fast, that could be a problem. Because you want to shoot out a tooth immediately. Doesn't seem too bad so far. Okay, and last one is with the gold teeth. Okay, yeah, I guess a good strategy is to, like, charge up a shot immediately. Oh yeah, this was easy. Oh, not done yet. Forgot. Yeah, charge up a shot immediately, because what happens is you'll shoot out the tooth in front of you. Usually it looked like it was one tooth, but you'll spread your ink around so you can safely exit. That fight might be kind of weird with a roller, though. I think most of these boss fights are going to be. Okay, but yeah, that was just as easy, if not easier, than with a regular weapon. Okay, but yeah, we unlock a mini game. I wonder if it tells you which one it is. Squid Ball, okay. Okay, and like I said, that is gonna be the last one for this video. Let's see if I can show it. I don't think there's a way to display it on the TV. Yeah, this only displays on the gamepad. This is pretty interesting, though. Okay, I'm not gonna, you know, mess with that too much, because you guys can't see that. Okay, but to sum it up, you get 3 pieces of clothing, a minigame, and then I believe the last one... Wow. The last one is a weapon? I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Yeah, it doesn't tell you what you unlock anymore. And you only get, was it 100 for completing each one again? So not that much anymore. Okay, but yeah, next time we will conclude the Inkling Girl amiibo challenges. Thanks for watching, and see you then.